talk about certain things that I am hearing about this country, and I'm talking about the United States for anyone who doesn't live here. It, for a long while, was hidden in a cloak, and it was this cloak of equality, togetherness, until people started to catch on and see that a lot of the traditions, is what I call it, has been going on. Same thing has been going on. Nothing has changed. It just updated. Like when your computer needs an update and your computer goes ahead and runs that update. It's like the phones and the laptops that we use and the TVs. Nothing looks the way it did 10 years ago, 20 years ago. So what would we expect? The very thing that built this country, the deviant behavior that went along with it, would just go away. That's not logical, and that's not the way it works. What has happened is we went from having our livelihoods and everything taken away from us, our culture, our names, everything, and we were brought into this land. And we built this country, and we have built every country around this world, because slaves were not just shipped to the New World, America. Slaves were shipped everywhere. So there's black people, dark people everywhere. They may try and hide them, but do rest assured, we're everywhere. Everything that you see, everything that you use, it was built on our back and our hard work. And to say that, you know, black people are lazy and things like that, I don't pay that any mind. I know that's just projection. But really, the start of it, you know, how they give you the story about the pilgrims. And they were escaping the tyranny from the crown. They didn't want to be dictated to. They didn't want to be treated a certain way. They wanted to live. It's very funny that we get that story, but then they come over here and slaughter hundreds of millions of people. And they oppress people and do worse things than they could ever have been put underneath. The crown and the start of this country, everything, economics, everything was built on the blood, sweat, bones of our family. And I'm sick of calling them ancestors. That is my family. When you see the mass graves that are being found, it's young people, young women, young men, babies and children, you know, worked to death, not beaten to death, but they were literally worked to death, muscle detaching from bone, babies and people starving to death. Even though they were gathering food, they couldn't eat it. They starved to death and had to work from sun up to sundown. And I don't even believe from sun up to sundown. I believe they had people working through the night if they needed to get something done. Because I already know how they do now. And a lot of people will say, you know, in the Civil War, we fought and died to release you. First of all, you should have never enslaved human beings in the first place. You never should have did the deviant behavior that you did in the first place. And then to think that you're going to get a Scooby snack or a cookie for an idea in your pea brain of what you did is... It's astounding to me. It's cognitive dissonance. I understand what it is, but just to let those words roll off your lips is unbelievable. To have that much bravery and the nerve to try and treat us today as if we are simple. minded. And that's the offensive thing about it. They're trying to treat us as if we are slow and we don't understand the same old tricks that they've been using for years, and the same rhetoric and everything. The only ones that they fool with this is the people who want to be around them, the people who are tired and they don't have energy to fight, and the ones who look just like them, pale. But the things that were going on in the past are still going on today. Even the brutality from the sexual rape of men, women, and children, to having people in slavery. That is what the prison industrial complex is. It is slavery, and it is sanctioned by this nation, brought to you by the Constitution of this nation. There's only a stipulation in slavery. That's the only thing that's been changed, is they will mark you as a criminal, and that's all that is. Every time you hear a byword, a nigger, a thug, now it's changed to criminalize black people to get them into slavery. Now, this is looting. They're a thief. They're a criminal. They're a thug. They're doing this, this, and this, and not taking into consideration or even explaining the economic situations that are going on, the hardships that are going on, which it's happening. It's purposely being done to black people to push them into a corner or push them into these situations. And they criminalize a desperate person who doesn't have anywhere to turn or anywhere to go or any means to even help themselves. They will then criminalize that person so they can get that person into slavery, which is a prison. And the rest of the upstanding good citizens, the ones that they say are really indentured servants. And that's what I call myself, an indentured servant. A person who works in the big house. They do tasks for the owners, or, you know, right now it's not basically being in the big house with a slave master. The slave master is now the CEO, and the plantation, the big house, the big houses have gotten bigger, and they are now called corporations. So nothing has changed. This is the same as in the start of this country. Even with Jim Crow, that is still going on today, which is a criminalization of anything that black people do. You see how if you're black and you're caught doing something, you're going to have to serve a sentence of 15 people. If you are pale and you are caught doing something, you will get away with it. Lynchings are still happening. They are being labeled as suicides. I don't know how you can hang yourself from a tree with your hands tied behind your back, but they did try to sell that. And also the judge who was Muslim, who they said, you know, she drowned herself because what she wanted to commit suicide. Like, that would be the easiest. So with the history of lynchings and how hard it is and how you struggle to take a breath if you are underwater, they want you to believe that, yeah, those are the ways that we would commit suicide, which we are the least to commit suicide. Because there is a religious thing where it said that we don't have the right to take our own lives because the Most High basically bought and paid for our lives and all of that. So to kill ourselves is very rare. It's very, very rare. And especially in those ways with the history behind it. So all of that is going on. The dismemberment of bodies is still going on. We recently heard about someone who basically got their heads cut off. The head was set on a patio and then the body was burned. And it's so many. Cops just shooting people, just shooting people for no reason. Their hands are up, they're laid on their back, they're laid on their front. Black females being cavity searched, which is rape. They are pulling down underwear in public and searching their private areas and filling them up and touching them. You can rest assured that if there is any prostitution going on, that these police officers, vice and Caucasian males are definitely raping women. They're raping them in prison as well. So a lot of this stuff has not stopped. It doesn't get reported on. They don't put it in mass media. They will blind you with celebrities and dumb shit. And I wanted to speak about the founding fathers. The founding fathers is something that I've also noticed is the difference between what I see and what a European sees. A European sees a hero. They started, the way they talk about them as they started this country, they were the innovators. They basically laid the foundation. They were not. To me, when I see them, I don't see someone who built a great nation. There's some black people who will say this too, which is disgusting to me. It makes me sick to my stomach when they can look to their last name. Why is your last name Smith? Why are there so many Smiths, Williams, and the common name Browns? Why are there so many? And we're not related or blood because we were underneath these slave owners. So we are still branded to this day. When I look at the founding fathers and all of the presidents, I see a bunch of murderers. I see a bunch of domestic terrorists. I see a bunch of men who were slave owners, which is an inhumane practice, especially what they did. I see very evil, wicked, demonic entities. That is what I see when I look at the founding fathers of this nation. When I look at that flag, I see the blood. I see it drenched in the blood of my family members. And when I hear these national songs, I hear a threat to my life. Being in this country is just, it's a lot. And to have to be around the collective of European, it really sucks the energy out of me. You do what you have to do as far as trying to survive, because that's basically what we're doing in this country. We're trying to survive the many ways of them trying to basically figure out what they're going to do with their leftover cargo. And they've been trying to figure that out for a while. And the reason why it hasn't been an all-out slaughter is because the rest of the world, they want to appear a certain way to the rest of the world. The devil doesn't like you to outright know who he is. He likes to, work in the dark. He likes to cloak who he is. And if he can figure out a way to make it look normal or to do whatever he wants to do. Or hide it. I wanted to say all of this because I'm not gonna listen to these people talk to me about the start of this country and how great and how high of an IQ that they have and how they built this nation and how we should be thankful that they took us from where we were. We weren't living in a pro. Who are you? They to say to us how we were living is not the proper way to live. No, it's just that a parasite saw the perfect host and they knew they had to find a host or they would die off. And we just ended up being that host that these parasites found. I mean, they continue to they just continue their traditions. They continue on, and this is going to be a part one of several because I want to talk about the NFL and the fact that they are well-paid slaves. You know what? They aren't even well-paid slaves. They are getting a fraction of what they are worth. And we gave up our Negro leagues to be integrated with them, and what did we get? I mean, really, what have we got? We have gotten in between a rock and a hard place when we decided to try to integrate. Not saying that it wasn't noble what was trying to be done, because one thing that they do is, let's say if they wanted to separate, I wouldn't trust them. You get one part of the country, you get half of the country, we get the other half of the country. I wouldn't believe that bullshit because you're gonna try and take all of the resources and everything and try and bring everything onto your side and leave us with absolutely nothing, like they do now, how they redline this whole country and leave us in pockets where we have little to work with, and they get all the resources and everything is better for them in their little areas. And yeah, these are just some things that I noticed that, we look at today. A lot of people, we don't pay attention and see that the same things are going on. It's like, because it's not outright like chattel slavery, we actually buy into, we're free and we can do what we want to do and we have opportunities and, everything is better when it's not. It just changed. It just evolved. It just, got an update, like your computer gets an update, like you go from the iPhone 3 and now we have the iPhone 8, right? It just changed, but the tradition is still going on to this day. Almost 400 years. But I'll go ahead and leave it right here. Let me know what you think. I mean, being a black person in this country, and let me know of some of the experiences that you went through, some of the things that you noticed that maybe other people didn't notice, maybe I didn't talk about, in your experience, and I will see you in the next one.
7 feet barren, strange fruit, blood on the leaves. And blood at the roots. Black bodies swinging in the southern breeze. Strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees.